Have you ever woken up in terror after having a bad dream in which you killed someone, or even worse, got together with your ex? You wake up and immediately embark on a frantic Google search journey. Am I a psychopath? Do I secretly still miss that guy that abused me? Are those just my deepest unfulfilled wishes? Sadly, there is no easy answer. Both Freud and Jung's theories on dreams are difficult to prove or disprove. So, rather than speculate about the meaning of dreams, what I'd prefer to do in today's video is to have a look at the science behind sleep. Hi, I'm Kat, and today I'll explain why sleep deprivation can, and most likely will, kill you. Prepare to be shocked. I know I was while reading Matthew Walker's book. But before we move on, just a quick shout out and a massive thank you to the sponsor of this video, Air Health. I will talk about them and their glorious CBD sleep oil a little bit later. For now, let's move on and see if I can convince you to go to bed a bit early tonight. I don't want to start off by scaring you, but I probably will. Did you know that unhealthy sleep equals unhealthy heart? Shorter sleep is associated with a 45% increased risk of developing or dying from coronary heart disease. One study showed that those sleeping 6 hours or less were 400 to 500% more likely to suffer one or more cardiac arrests than those sleeping over 6 hours. Not enough sleep can also result in an overactive sympathetic system, which pretty much means that your body is, to some degree, in the fight or flight state all the time. So it kind of is like having a low-key panic attack all day long. Moreover, sleeping less than 7 or 8 hours a night will increase your probability of gaining weight, being overweight or obese, and will significantly increase your likelihood of developing type 2 diabetes. This is because not enough sleep increases the production of the hunger hormone ghrelin and reduces the production of the satiety hormone leptin. And as though that wasn't enough, when you're sleep deprived while dieting, 70% of the weight you lose will come from your muscles, not fat, which is obviously not ideal. Furthermore, insufficient sleep across the lifespan now seems to be one of the most significant lifestyle factors determining whether or not you'll develop Alzheimer's. Bear with me because the list is long and it actually gets worse. Not enough sleep can also affect your reproductive system. Men who sleep 5 to 6 hours a night have smaller testicles than those who sleep 7 hours or longer. Sleep deprivation will age you by a decade in terms of testosterone levels, and you'll have a 29% lower sperm count. 29%, that's almost a third. It affects women too, of course. Sleeping less than 6 hours a night results in a 20% drop in follicular releasing hormone in women, a critical element that's necessary for conception. Now, add this to a 33% higher rate of irregular menstrual cycles in women who don't get enough sleep. That is how you get the perfect environment for fertility issues. Now, something a bit less dramatic. The less you sleep, the more likely you are to catch a cold. And back to shocking numbers. In one study, people were allowed to sleep for 6 hours a night, for just 1 week, not 2, 3, 4, just 1 week of sleep deprivation. This resulted in the distortion of the activity of 711 genes. The ones that got turned off are responsible for your immune response. Those that were overexpressed, or let's say more active, are responsible for the promotion of tumors, chronic inflammation, and stress. While we're on the subject of cancer, in another study, sleep-deprived mice suffered a 200% increase in the speed and size of cancer growth relative to the well-rested group. What's even worse, the tumours were far more aggressive and spread to surrounding organs more easily.
I'm afraid there's more. Shift workers have higher rates of cancer. In fact, we now know that insufficient sleep is linked to bowel, breast, and prostate cancer.
In fact, the World Health Organization has decided to classify any form of nighttime shift work as a probable carcinogen. And last but not least, according to one study, just one night of 4 hours of sleep results in 70% reduction of critical cancer-fighting immune cells naturally existing in our bodies. Mind fucking blown.
I know, it's absolutely insane. Why is no one talking about this? In fact, you being awake right now is causing low-level brain damage, but don't worry about it too much because it is then reversed when you get some good sleep. To sum up, the shorter you sleep, the shorter you live. And the quality of that now shorter life is significantly worse.
Now, apart from those strictly physical aspects, sleep, both non-REM and REM, can do wonders for those slightly less tangible elements. First of all, it works as a memory aid, both before learning, to prepare your brain for making new memories, and after learning, to prevent you from forgetting them.
It's not just knowledge though, it's skills too.
So you'll learn a new skill much faster when you get proper sleep after a day of practicing. So let's say you're trying to learn how to play the piano, or paint, or anything that's got to do with motor skills. The more good quality sleep you get, the better you'll become.
We also sleep to forget so that our brain can delete stored information we no longer need. And it gets better when we actually dream.
Dreaming about traumatic events that have caused us great pain can actually help us heal and reduce the depression caused by those events. And by suppressing noradrenaline and providing better REM sleep, you can significantly improve symptoms of PTSD, reducing the amount of daytime flashbacks and nighttime nightmares.
There's more good stuff coming.
Dreaming also aids creativity and problem solving because, to simplify it, and I'm really, really simplifying it here, when we dream, the prefrontal cortex, that thing in your brain that's responsible for rational thinking, it turns off. That means that the other parts of your brain can roam free and come up with things you'd never be able to come up while awake. This is also the reason why your dreams are so wacky and rarely make much sense.
Phew! That was a lot of knowledge packed into just a few minutes, but hopefully you're still awake and I have managed to show you why good sleep is really, really important.
So you may be wondering now, how many hours do I need? Well, the consensus is that somewhere between 7 and 9 hours a night is optimal. But it's not just the quantity, it's also the quality. You need both non-REM and REM sleep. Good news is that there are quite a few things you can do to sleep better.
But before we move on, I would like to come back to the sponsor of this video, Air Health, and introduce you to their absolutely, absolutely glorious CBD oil.
Inside this glorious sleep elixir, you'll get full spectrum CBD, a special formulation of terpenes to help you fall asleep. You also get lavender extract and the good old melatonin, the darkness hormone responsible for regulating the circadian rhythm.
This little bottle is an absolute lifesaver for me and actually it is a lifesaver quite literally because it helps me sleep and as we've just learned, sleep is super important to, well, pretty much stay alive. You probably all know by now that I've been an anxious, stressed wreck for the past few months now. Oh God, probably longer. And it's really not easy for me to fall asleep, no matter what I do. And so, sadly, I self-medicate with alcohol. A little bit more, probably, than I would have liked. And it's clearly and obviously not the best long-term solution for my problems. So instead of drinking myself to sleep, I prefer to use the CBD sleep oil whenever I can. So anyway, without exaggeration, this is actually one of the most valuable possessions of mine right now. So if you want to check it out, you can have a look at all of the links down below. And now, moving on to all the other good stuff that you can do to sleep better. First of all, try to stay regular and go to bed roughly around the same time each night. You can also have a hot bath or a hot shower about 2 hours before bedtime, and this works best when followed by going to bed in a cool room. Turning the lights down in the evenings can also work wonders, so instead of having bright, big lights turned on, go for a nice, dimmed little lamp in the corner. And last but not least, the infamous blue light. The screens. The one thing that we've all heard of, and yet somehow we choose to ignore it every single night. Did you know that 1 hour of iPad reading delays the release of melatonin by 3 hours? We stay on our phones or laptops till late, and then we're shocked by the fact that we can't sleep. So just choose a book instead. They never fail to help me fall asleep. And that's about it. I would highly recommend reading this book. The science behind sleep is absolutely fascinating. I obviously could not fit everything into this video. So yeah, well done if you made it till the end. I tried my best to not use my super calm, drowsiness-inducing voice today. So yeah, well done if you made it till the end. Thank you for watching, and I hope you sleep well. Bye!